Thank you, Johannes. It's a big pleasure for us to be here with you for these 2 days, and we really invested a lot of efforts to come. Johannes is our old friend and expert who has been engaged as of 2011 in Western Balkans, and I'm pleased to present myself. I'm an interim director of Regional School of Public Administration. We are located in Montenegro, and we are organized as an international organization, even though many think that we are just a project. Western Balkan countries, jointly with the EU Commission, decided to boost collaboration and to actually stimulate public administration reform and strengthen and fasten EU integration process. This was very difficult because the Western Balkan region was fulfilled with a lot of conflicts, wars, and our intention and our mission was not only to deal with something content-wise related, but also to provide the reconciliation of the relations. So I'm very much proud to say that so far RESPA member countries are Bosnia and Herzegovina, Albania, Serbia, Macedonia, and Montenegro, and we are expecting Kosovo hopefully to join us. And we are having here also with us in the target audience is also representatives from the whole region, and to our pleasure, those are not just the civil servants, those are senior professionals, and we have actually tried with them to formulate our overall objectives, not only in e-government, because our primary target areas are human resource management, EU integration, public administration reform, public-private partnership, public procurement, and the others. So the gentlemen and the ladies sitting here with us from the Western Balkans are experts in e-government, and they helped us to understand how, as a middleman in the region, we can facilitate the exchange of experiences and how we can actually also transfer the know-how from the world and also from the European Union. What we also learned so far after celebrating the 50th anniversary last year is that the region has also accumulated a lot of experiences and a lot of knowledge. And to our understanding, the people with whom we are working and who are partners in the e-government working group of ours are not only the officials but also capable of individuals who can transfer the know-how also to the other countries in Europe and into the world. I may confidently conclude that we are ready and mature enough to receive the knowledge and to receive the best practices and to customize and utilize, of course, with the support of the EU Commission and EU and worldwide experts, but also to reproduce the similar effect to the other countries in the world and also in the European Union. We have been so far dealing with the trainings, but then we understood that having a holistic approach and the need to strengthen the decision makers. Today here with us there is also one governing board members of ours, Yehia, who has helped us a lot with other governing board members to formulate the networking events, and also research studies and publications, 11 of theirs are available on our website. E-government has been placed in 2012. A year when we actually started this very intensive network of ours after on called working group, and we have done so far the first study in 2012. It was comparison between us and the UN indicators in terms of monitoring of e-government and informatics society in the world. It was followed by another two studies. The second one, it was in 2014, study on abuse of information technology for corruption. And building up on yesterday's comment from the lady from Kyrgyzstan, we have actually wanted also to highlight the importance of this study, because so far, and confirmed with the OECD and United Nations, it is one of the very first of this kind in the world. Our e-government respective network members and experts engaged actually defined the need for such an innovative approach. The study was very interesting, and it can be downloaded from our website, and we can share with you later on the electronic versions. Stimulated our working group members and the institutions in the region to foster RESPA to work jointly with them in formulating methodology, which at the end was called Checklist for Assessment of Risks of Abuse of IT for Corruption. This methodology is very much replicable. We have had already an interest shown from a regional hub in Kazakhstan and other countries like Azerbaijan when I visited them 3 months ago. And we would be also happy to say that it was piloted in the Western Balkan countries for the second pilot activity. For example, in Serbia, it is to be encompassed into the self-assessment toolkit to be implemented on all institutions in the country. In the previous stage, it was meant only for 5,000 institutions, and now we expect to be done on the national level. And the last one, which I will pass the floor to my colleague, the expert Bojan Cvetković, to speak about, is the study that we done last year in 2015 from mid to open government study. Before I leave the floor, I wish to welcome you all in Montenegro and Respa, and I hope that we will be able to establish further collaboration with Estonian colleagues, but also with all of you. So you're welcome to approach us. Our colleagues are here, so we are also able to network with you and to communicate, so we will be glad to further our communication. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello, everybody. My name is Bojan Cvetković, and I'm a regional RESPA expert. I worked on several studies, and I'm very happy to be here. The study E2Open e-government study was done in November 2015 as practically a new version of the study that was done in late 2012 and published in 2013 with several additions, important additions in regard to the first study. We needed to follow up the first study, but idea was to support and examine the business processes, the open government business processes, the trends and the potentials that have arise from 2012 and 2013. One structure reflects EU good practices, particularly in e-government and open government. And the focus was entirely on the RESPA member countries, as Goran previously said, and Kosovo. So we wanted to examine 2015 practically state of the e-government and open government in Western Balkans. What are the successes, what are the lessons learned, and we wanted to identify the past and current challenges. Important focus was on processes and outcomes of provision of information, of service delivery, and to so-called G2X interactions, so government to citizen, business, and also to government to civil society organizations. But what is important that the new issues that were examined were open government data, open government platform, civil society, private partnership, and public civic partnership. This is the, and also the cloud computing was the one thing that was identified as being very important to the development of the e-government. Findings elaborated the individual countries on policy and strategic level, on specific institutional settings, on relation with public administration reform. And this was especially important because practically the recommendations were given in regard to EU and open government in relation to public administration reforms. And public administration reforms were evaluated using Sigma priorities. Sigma priorities is this is a new initiative based on the basic principles of monitoring and evaluation that were defined between the in the cooperation between EU and OEPS and OECD. And I really recommend that you use these basic principles of monitoring and evaluation because I heard a lot about the development of e-government for these days. Sorry, and I heard that you are using business intelligence systems for the monitoring and evaluation. But really, it's just simple as the five principles of monitoring and evaluation that EU and OECD prescribed for any kind of project, including the e-government. So use these recommendations of the EU and OECD. What are the highlights of this study? Well, practically, we needed to identify the areas that are most needed to improve capacity in order to use e-government for public administration reform. Then we needed to identify the need for horizontal vertical networking within the institutions, within the countries, and what's especially important within the region, because as we heard from the first day, the cross-border cooperation is becoming much more important today. And also we needed to see the cross-cutting nature of the EU open government and to see the importance, you know, that there is a great fear of implementing e-government in public administration. So we needed to highlight the importance of enabling e-government. You know, I won't bother you with the Sigma priorities. You can look for Sigma priorities on the Sigma priorities website, and on this I will go directly to general observations of the study. So it's clear now that e-government is really the basis for developing efficient government, and the open government also is one of the pillars, you know. What is the general observation is that there is a very close coherence between e-government and open government. So nowadays they cannot be separated. In the beginning of the development of the e-government systems, they could be separated. Simply open government and open government data and platform did not exist, but nowadays they cannot be separated. And also your presentations show that. Our study shows that leading e-government implementation that leading countries in Western Balkans regarding e-government implementations are also leading the open government implementation. Currently, the e-government in Western Balkans is focused on initial development, going to the some middle phase and final phase, and that is digitizing the back office and front office online services. This is good basis for the final implementation of e-government and open government, but this is not yet fully established, because some technical infrastructure is needed, organizational infrastructure, also the competence of the people in public administrations need to be builded, the capacity building is needed, and what is most important, the political support is still somewhat lacking in that the public administration in these countries are fairly large, and the political parties and political leadership cannot always support the full implementation of e-government and open government. But it's coming there. Open government use of ICT is very simple. It needs to make e-government transparent, fully transparent, because for the clients, for the users, e-government is still government. They don't care what is behind. They simply need a service. So this is why open government is very important. Simply, in Western Balkan countries, progress to open government still needs some basis and still needs some initiatives. I won't, you know, because there is not enough time, I won't go through the recommendations for each country. You can, as Goran said, you can download the study and look. It's a large study, so I won't go there. I want to focus on these external assistance recommendations, meaning that you know. And external assistance is needed in Western Balkan countries in areas of strategic and legislative support, in technical support, in support for cloud services, because many of the Western Balkan countries implemented cloud years ago, but simply they did not utilize it the way you did, you know, the way you showed us here that it's possible. Support for open data initiatives are also something that we are looking forward to work with Estonian colleagues, and also organization and capacity building. So practically, each of the countries is different, but they have the some sort of common need for the external assistance. And what are the methods for this? What can be done? Workshops, trainings, training networks, regional center of excellences, boot camps, exchanges and visits to your countries, and your countries can come to Respa also. Then Respa needs and will focus support to individual countries, because each country needs something different. Regional comparative studies is something that Respa is doing already, so it's nothing new. General recommendations, and I will finish with this. Then the representatives of the countries will say their messages to you. Is to align the work of e-government working group of Respa with the European e-government action plan that I think that is already adopted, and it is aligned with the EU 2020 strategy. And also the planning for the future initiatives practically are based in some important fields. One is the field of co-creation and collaboration, meaning that we need to engage citizens and business in creation of the services and in contents of the services. Public civil partnerships and public-private partnerships are very important, and this was my question on the first days to the representatives of the companies that were talking about about does money utilize you, the good e-government, reusable and modular public services. Simply, governments change, and e-government needs to be modular in order to change with each government, because each government has different focus. Today, the focus is on investment, and the other day will be focused on something else, so the e-government needs to be modular. And to be modular, we need some generic building blocks of e-government, and I think that Moldova presentation did a very good example of generic building blocks for the e-government. And in order to come to something that we call digital service infrastructure for e-government, or for any other service. And just to close, Respa will continue to have a close cooperation with everybody, with work group, and with Western Balkans countries on these issues of PPP, PCP, and e-government, and of course of open data. Thank you, and I leave the floor to each individual country.